Hello and welcome back to Brocher's Adventures here on YouTube. My name is Derek Brocher and today I'm going to be talking about the Airport Helipack from Think Tank Photo. And full disclosure, I'm not getting paid by Think Tank Photo to discuss this bag at all. I actually asked them after I bought my drone to send me one for review purposes because I hadn't seen a lot of Altel X-Star premiums with this bag, so I thought I would be one of the few to do that. So first off, as you can tell, the bag is a pretty rigid bag. It's got good padding on the back. It's got two main baggage straps here for when you're in the airport. It's also got one on the bottom if your luggage shifts or anything in the overhead bin of the plane, you can pull it out. And then if you flip it around, it has your standard backpack straps that are adjustable, also with the sternum strap so that you can get a little bit more stability with the bag. And then if you're carrying heavier loads, you've got these waist straps, just like you would with bigger backpacks. And if you're a backpacker or you go hiking or anything like that, you're familiar with these. These just come around your waist to take a little bit of the weight off of your shoulders when you're actually walking around. All right, I'm gonna flip it around and we'll take a look in the front pocket here. So as you can see in the front pocket, it's got room for a laptop or an iPad or anything like that. It's actually got quite a bit of room. It goes down the entire front here. And then it's got a bunch of these little pouches that you can kind of see for cables or pens or pencils or miscellaneous items. As we go into the main compartment here, I've actually left this in here. It comes with a little layout of how the drone is supposed to fit in there, as well as accessories, batteries, and that kind of stuff. I take this layout as a general guideline because I've got a lot more stuff than just this, but I'll just throw that off to the side there. It comes with a little register to win card and what looks to be a little brochure of, yep, it's exactly what it is, a little brochure of more bags and stuff they have for other occasions. Again, I'm just gonna toss that. And you can see right here in front, we've got where the drone sits, the main compartment, with these four compartments around it, which you can put batteries, you can put a lot of other things in here. In this bottom one, you see this blue rain cover. You can take that out right there, and they actually supplied this with the pack, which is really nice. A lot of bags and a lot of companies don't do that. This compartment right here is the main compartment for the controller, but as you can see, these are all Velcro, so I could make any configuration within this bag that I wanted. And that's one of the reasons I wanted to try out this bag, is because I have a lot of photo equipment that I take with me on my travels, as you might notice. But this drone is pretty new and I needed something that I could transport it without having the big bulky hard shell case that comes with the X-Star. And since I do travel overseas quite a bit, it is great that this is regulation size for most carry-on bags in the world, which means I shouldn't have a problem, maybe the occasional stop to check out what's actually in it, because a lot of people don't see drones coming through the airport. Then I'll flip this around and you can see we've got all these little zipper compartments here. We've got three of them and they're actually large enough that you can put extra cables, you can put your propellers and stuff like that in here. I think this was a great addition because it just makes it so easy to access stuff when you open up the bag. And then they also supplied these, which are little rubber tips that you put on the motors here, so that when you put it in the bag, it doesn't scratch or kind of chew at these mesh pockets. I'll just set those right back in there for now. Overall, this bag is pretty much like a camera bag that you would find from any other company, except it is for drones. It's specifically made to fit DJI, X-Star, and a few other drones that I can't remember the names of right now. And I do have the X-Star Premium, which should fit snugly in here. One more thing I forgot to say is about the zippers. They're actually pretty heavy duty. I can't imagine that these zippers would really break on me. They're actually the, I think there's a little tag for them here. They're the YKK zippers, which are known to be durable, and they're actually kind of expensive zippers. The handle is padded as well on the side and top, and so are the shoulder pads. And then they have also some kind of custom fit padding here that's got some mesh on the outside to make it a little bit more breathable. And it's in the shape of your back and shoulders, so it should fit pretty well and be pretty comfortable. All right, so to prove to you that this is the right bag for me and traveling, I'm actually going to take most of the stuff. This isn't everything that I take. I've got the cameras that I'm using right here, as you can tell, but I normally carry either those on a hip pouch or on the GorillaPod tripod with me for vlogging and stuff like that, so they generally don't go in the bag. But I'm gonna take most of the stuff that I use and put it in the bag. All right, so first I'm gonna go with this outside pocket that's meant for the laptop and accessories. And I've got my 15-inch MacBook Pro over here, and that fits in pretty snug. I mean, look at that, it just slid right in. I think these are meant for 17-inch or could handle a 17-inch because there's plenty of room. I could even put an iPad on top of that in the computer pouch. Next, I am going to take the charger here and also the manual and instructions for the X-Star Premium. Just put that right down at the bottom. Take the charger, put that on top right there. What else could I fit in here? Lens cap, that's easy enough. Just toss it in a small pocket. I'm gonna have to do this upside down because this is facing me, which is easier to pack the pockets and easier for you to see as well. So I've got the top pocket here, which, let's see, I've got a memory card box that fits all my memory cards for my cameras, a few security locks for TSA, toss those in there, as well as a security cable, and I generally keep the security cable with me because I can strap a backpack to a tree or a bench or something like that, something that's stationary in the airport or on a beach or anything like that, so nobody can take the bag, or at least we'll have a tough time doing it if they want to. All right, so those fit easily in the top. I was talking about the blade compartment, which I'll just put these in the bottom here, easily accessible for when I need to fly. And then this middle pocket, I've got a bunch of miscellaneous cables, iPhone cables, Samsung cables, GoPro cables, all really just charging cables, so I'll toss those in the middle. Not being very gentle with them, but oh well. All right, that is three pockets down. Now I'm gonna go and I'm gonna put everything, the rest of this, into all of these pockets. First of all, I'll pad around where the aircraft should go. So I'll actually take my Canon lens, and I think this should fit under one of the rotors. Might as well put the controller in while I'm up here. Controller fits nicely. Go with the GoPro chesty strap. Stuff that under a rotor. Got the GoPro dive casing with a suction cup mount that I'm just gonna slide right up here. That actually fits pretty perfectly. Always carry a bag of miscellaneous GoPro parts and accessories with me just in case I need anything. There's some filters in here and some other connectors. I'll put that in this side, should be fine. I'll actually put that down a little bit and I can put some more stuff on top of it in a little bit. So I've got the GoPro extendable three-way tripod here, or hand grip. I'm just gonna toss that in. I think it should work in one of these compartments. All right, so this right here is the charging unit for the controller and for the batteries for the X-Star Premium. I think they'll just fit right over here just fine. As you can tell, I don't care too much about where the cables go as long as I can fit other things around them. Battery will do nice up here. Got a few hard drives and a battery pack. Take the hard drives here for my computer, power bank. Can slip in the side there. The head strap for the GoPro can go under another. All right, we've got some battery charging packs here. I'm just gonna toss those on top of the GoPro accessories. Charging box here has four USB on the side, three standard American plugs, and then has an international adapter here so I can plug it in anywhere in the world, and it actually is a step-down converter. Now I've got the X-Star Premium in orange right here with my FAA number on top. Yes, it is registered. It's a 4K camera with a removable gimbal, and this is about the exact same size as the DJI Phantom series drone, so it should fit perfectly in here. Just gotta move some of this stuff down. So it fits in there nice and snug. I've actually got two rotors out here to show you that you don't have to take all of the rotors off when you're not flying. You can just spin them on and leave two of them on in the bag. Now that I've got the drone in here with the propellers on, I'm actually going to flip the bag closed and put it on. I mean, weight-wise, it's not light, but it's not heavy either. Definitely something that I'm used to with carrying around a lot of photo equipment. Now it does look a little bit big, I understand that, but that's the price of having a drone and all the photo equipment with me. And with this waist strap, I should be able to carry it for a while without tiring out my shoulders or my back. So that's my review of the ThinkTank Photo Airport Helipack. And like I said before, I'm not being paid to make this review, but I do love this bag and I'm definitely going to keep it and use it for a while. I have an upcoming trip to Australia, so this should be a big asset for me. Thank you again for watching this video, and if you'd like to see more like it on my channel, please subscribe below for the newest content. It does help me out and give me the motivation to keep bringing you more travel-related content. Safe travels, and remember, you don't have to spend a fortune to have an adventure.
Three. Thank you.
No problem.
Menu.
Don't eat menu.
Oh, this one right here is a little vicious.